So, you believe the moon landing was fake? 9/11 was an inside job. COVID-19 is caused by 5G. The Illuminati rule the New World Order. And Queen Elizabeth is a shape-shifting, blood-drinking lizard. Stick around. You're gonna love the next 5 minutes. Drop that beat. This is Mfufu Mbeke Mbok. I am the leader of the WTF Army, and I want you to like, to share, and to comment on this video. And then I want you to subscribe and hit the great notification bell, because Milton White, Mick Moore, and JNews, they are dropping videos every week for your entertainment. And I need 10,000 soldiers and subscribers so I can take over New Zealand. Would you not like to rule New Zealand with me? I can make it happen as your leader. Now, here's the video. Go! You know, someone once asked me, Milton White, are you one of those conspiracy theorists? To which I replied, why? Who are you working for? Yes, it's easy to spot a conspiracy theorist because pretty much any conversation and anything you say brings out the crazy. It's a nice day for a drive. Yeah, you know who else went for a drive? JFK, and he was killed by the CIA. Wake up, man! Yes, some people believe that JFK was an alien who came from outer space, and that's why he knew the moon landing was fake. And the Jews shot him because he was about to expose that they were monetizing the stock market and space missions. I got a theory, man. What if JFK's neck just exploded on its own? Prove it didn't. You know, some people believe the Earth is flat, which is weird because they still say down under. If you believe that the Earth is flat, wouldn't you just say, over there? Flat earthers, you have nothing to fear except sphere itself. But you know what they say about flat earthers and A-cups? Once you go flat, you can never go back. Albert Einstein once said, the universe has a boundary, but human stupidity doesn't. And as Mark Twain also said, never argue with stupid people, they'll drag you down to their level and beat you with experience. It's very hard to beat a conspiracy theorist in an argument, because these people are not dealing with logic. In fact, the only way to beat a conspiracy theorist in an argument is to simply out-crazy them. Man, 9/11 was an inside job. I saw the missile with my own eyes. You fool! You believe in your eyes? Vision is just a mental representation of our hearing, but the Illuminati media moguls don't want you to know that so they can keep milking us. Wake up, man! Yes, it's the Illuminati, the shape-shifting, blood-drinking lizard people who control the world and rule everything that we do. Personally, I believe conspiracy theories are bullshit. Because you know what? Governments just aren't that organized. Don't believe me? Try changing your name and address on a government website. Just see how confusing it is. Take UFOs, for example. Well, UFOs, already conspiracy theory within itself. But the average conspiracy theorist goes, UFOs? That's not enough. They're coming to Earth to abduct us to do scientific anal probes, man. Really? So what you're telling me is that a hyper-intelligent being from outer space has traveled millions of light years all the way here to look up your unemployed and unwashed butt? That's not science. That's a fetish of intergalactic proportions. In fact, you find this in popular video games around the world, except Australia.
In the board's opinion, a weapon designed to penetrate the anus of enemy characters and civilians constitutes a visual depiction of implied sexual violence that is interactive and not justified by context, and as such, the game should be refused classification.
You see, in Australia, we don't like simulated anal probes. We prefer the government to come around and do it in person. But Milton, you say, what if it's all true? What if aliens do exist? How do I protect myself? Well, let me tell you. You see, in the US and in the UK, you can buy alien abduction insurance. Yep, it costs you $150 a year, and it protects you from probes and otherworldly things. Now, you might laugh, over 30,000 people have bought this insurance. Which to me is ridiculous, because what I figure is, what if a spaceship crash-landed a million years ago, wiped out all the dinosaurs, and we're the aliens? Think about it. Neil Armstrong, first man on the moon. Put it on the screen, J Newts. Neil A. Now, spell it backwards. You know what the problem with the scientific community and mainstream media is? It's full of people with degrees, qualifications, research and decades of experience. And everyone knows that's a bullshit way to approach anything. Which is why I personally to get my facts from social media and live in a bubble. Princess Di, right? She were killed by Donald Trump because she were having his baby, weren't she? Which is Prince Harry. And he married that black woman, right? Because he is trying to breed out the black race with his ginger sperm. Prove it ain't true. You know something? Maybe I'm wrong, thinking that all this conspiracy stuff is just all, you know, airy-fairy, tin hat stuff. Maybe there's something to it. You know what? I got a friend of mine, he's a frog scientist. He's pretty switched on about all that sort of stuff. I'm going to give him a call, and I'm going to see what he says. Hey, Alex, all this conspiracy theory stuff, I mean, is it true? And if it is, what's the thing that upsets you the most about it?
I don't like them putting chemicals in the water that turn the friggin' frogs gay. Do you understand that? Turn the friggin' frogs gay. Boom, boom, serious crap. Gay. Frogs, friggin' frogs, boom. It's not funny. I'm gonna say it real slow for you. Gay. Frogs!
All these conspiracy theories about Jeffrey Epstein are completely ridiculous. I mean, the man clearly killed himself because he had nothing left to live for.